Madam, Mr. Prime Minister, do you have any respect for commitments made by your predecessors? Indeed, should you even have a choice? What value does the word of a Prime Minister given on the floor of the House have? Can we believe that if you give an assurance, it will be fulfilled in the future, even if you are not around? How can we function as a nation if we can't take the word of our Prime Minister given in Parliament to be respected and fulfilled? Madam, it is not that BJP was opposed to special category status when it was in the opposition. In fact, the BJP in its 2014 manifesto for assembly elections in AP assured that it would give additional 5 years of status, that is 10 years instead of the 5 years proposed by then Prime Minister. Mr. Prime Minister, in Guntur, in Nellur, in Tirupati, in front of Lord Balaji, you promised to give SCS for 10 years. And you also emphasized an appeal to the people of AP to decide whether they need a Seam Andhra or a Scam Andhra. That is, do you want to vote for Seam Andhra? Do you want to vote for a clean and honest person like Chandrababu Naidu, or do you want to have a Scam Andhra by voting for the opposition rival party, Madam? Madam, Mr. Prime Minister, you also said, I'm a person who will not eat or allow others to eat. Main chun chun ke hisab lunga un lagam ko. But to the other disappointment for your benefit, sir. But to the other disappointment of the people, you are protecting people like Galla Jayadev Reddy, A1 and A2 accused in Andhra Pradesh, and many others. The country is aware how many cases were on the family members of Galla Jayadev Reddy were dismissed, and tickets were given in the recent Karnataka Assembly elections. This reflects how serious you are on corruption and on corrupt people. You raise the expectations of supporting and developing Andhra Pradesh only to shatter them. Why should we have confidence and trust in you? Now you are singing a different tune, which people of AP are keenly observing. And I have no doubt they would give a befitting reply in the coming elections. I even go to the extent of saying that the BJP will be decimated in Andhra Pradesh, the way Congress was, if the people of AP are deceived and cheated. Mr. Prime Minister, it is not a threat. This is sharp. These are the words coming out of anguish, pain and frustration from the people of Andhra Pradesh. And how a Prime Minister, on whom we had immense faith, has deceived and betrayed the people of AP in such a blatant and rude manner. The third point I wish to make is relating to Article 4 of the Constitution. It says that when any state is bifurcated under Article 3, AP is divided under this article, Madam, then supplemental, incidental and consequential measures can be taken by Parliament. Madam, the third point I wish to make is relating to Article 4 of the Constitution. It says that when any state is bifurcated under Article 3 and AP is bifurcated under this article, Madam, then supplemental, incidental and consequential measures can be taken by Parliament. And even the Supreme Court in Pradeep Chaudhary and the Mulla Periyar cases repeatedly said this, Madam. Yes. So the point I'm trying to drive at is that the very bifurcation of the state is predicated upon assurance of special category status. Therefore, the SCS is supplemental, incidental and consequential to the bifurcation, Madam. And to say that the 14th Finance Commission has not recommended is a conceptual blunder of the Union Government, Madam.
Yes.
So when it is clearly said in Article 4 that Parliament can do it, the 14th Finance Commission or its recommendations cannot prevent Parliament from doing it, even if they had said so, Madam. Madam, the Finance Minister and almost the entire Cabinet have been categorical that the 14th Finance Commission recommended not to confer SCS on any state. Let me disband, dismantle and dismiss this argument at one go, Madam.
Okay.
Two members of the 14th Finance Commission have refuted the argument of the Finance Minister lock, stock and barrel. Sri Govind Rao and Sri Abhijit Sen gave it in writing that the Commission did not recommend this. Even the Chairman of the 14th Finance Commission, Sri YV Reddy Garu, is on record saying that Commission did not recommend this. Let me quote, due to paucity of time, what Sri Govind Rao, Member 14th Finance Commission, has said on SCS. He said, and I quote, the additional terms of reference merely stated that the commission should go into should take into account the resources available to the successor or reorganized states in accordance with the AP Reorganization Act and the Ministry of Home Affairs notification. That did not require the commission to deal with the question of according special category status, and it did not therefore make any recommendation in that regard. Therefore, the statement in the notification on the special package that following the recommendations of the 14th Finance Commission, the class of SCS ceases to exist is misleading, unquote. Madam, let me give one more example of how the government of India has maneuvered through this and denied SCS to Andhra Pradesh. As I said, ministers and officials in the government are taking shelter under the 14th Finance Commission to deny SCS to Andhra Pradesh. I would like to assert here that prospective recommendations of various commissions, even if there are any to that effect, cannot be made applicable retrospectively to the past commitments, assurances, and decisions, Madam. The 14th Finance Commission recommendations are prospective. How can you implement them retrospectively? Here, in this case, it is the decision of the Union Cabinet, and it is not an ordinary decision, Madam. In this context, I would like to recapitulate that the Union Government had created a subgroup of CMs to address the issue of continuation of special category status to the Northeast and to the Hilly States, which are enjoying the same in the past. Based on the recommendations of the said subgroup, Niti Aayog had issued an office memorandum on 17th August 2016, whereby it was decided to continue special category status benefits to those states that were in that category earlier. Subsequently, it has extended the financial and other benefits to them as well. So they're getting everything that special category status states used to get without the name, Madam. So when we have been demanding for special category status, your argument, Mr. Finance Minister, is that the Planning Commission was dismantled and Niti Aayog has no mandate to give SCS to any state. If that is so, how, on the basis of office memorandum dated 17th August 2016, have you extended SCS benefits to all 11 states that fall under special category status? Is it not discrimination and injustice to Andhra Pradesh? Did you not mislead us about the 14th Finance Committee recommendations? And did you not also state that it would be unconstitutional to go against these alleged recommendations? Madam, I have one more irrefutable and undeniable truth and proof to present before this August House. I hope that this will open the eyes of the Finance Minister and the Prime Minister. It was on 15th March 2018, the Minister of Planning, Sri Rao Inderjit Singh, in reply to an unstarred question number 2360 in the Rajya Sabha said, and I quote, Madam, the 14th Finance Commission in its recommendations has not made any specific reference not to confer special category status to any state. So, Honorable Finance Minister, kindly stop misleading the people by twisting facts because it won't work anymore. All the proof is in front of you. You can't fool all of the people all of the time, sir.
Yes.
Madam, I have given seven facts and justifications. Pardon?
How much time you need?
Madam, I still need a lot more time.
I am asking you how much time
I need. Another half an hour, madam.
No half an hour. That's
yes, madam.
No. 5 minutes.
Madam, in the history of no confidence motion, nobody has initiated a discussion less than 1 hour, madam. You please see the records. I looked at the records. Not once has a no confidence motion been initiated in less than 1 hour, madam. Please don't discriminate us here also. We're tired of this type of discrimination.
Yes.
Madam, I have given seven facts and justifications why special category status should be conferred on Andhra Pradesh. They are, and to recap, assurance by none other than Prime Minister candidate Ms. Modi ji during the 2014 election campaign. Ours is not a demand, madam. Ours is to implement the cabinet decisions. The BJP manifesto said that it will give SCS for 10 years. Article 4 of the Constitution clearly and categorically says that if state is bifurcated under Article 3, then supplemental, incidental, and consequential measures can be taken by Parliament. Written views of members of the 14th Finance Commission and also views of the chairman of 14th Finance Commission on the special category status. Niti Aayog has issued office memorandum on 17th August 2016, where it was decided to continue SCS to 11 states. The Minister of Planning clearly said that 14th Finance Commission has never recommended not to confer SCS on any state. Even the CMs of Bihar and Puducherry have support granting SCS to Andhra Pradesh, Madam.